to a news conference.
Let him go! Bismillah!
We will not let you go!
Let me go!
We'll not let you go!
Let me go!
We'll not let you go!
Let me go!
Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia!
Mamma mia, let me go! Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me! For me! For me!
Freddie, Bohemian Rhapsody was your first worldwide success. Were you surprised when that became a hit?
I think so. Well, Bohemian Rhapsody was a very big surprise because it was like a... it was a risk because, I mean, at that time, a seven-minute single, I think it was seven minutes, was not allowed and the radios wouldn't play and so we took a big risk. So it was either, we thought it was either going to be a big hit or a big flop.
You've been together 14 years now, and at one stage you took an 18-month break from each other because, in your own words, you hated each other's guts. How difficult has it been to stay together all this time?
It's terribly difficult.
What have been the major problems?
I think it's like a marriage, really. You know, you love each other, but you hate each other at times as well, really, you know. And it's you're stuck together a lot of the time. You go everywhere together, you know, and the time comes when you just need a bit of breathing space, and over the years we've just learned to give each other a bit of space. Actually, I mean, we joke about it, but I mean, we get on fine.
A lot of Queen's success can be attributed to your videos. How important are videos to a group?
Well, you get bad videos like you get bad records, you know. Some of them are awful, some of them are good, and some of them make the record sound worse because it gives you preconceived visual ideas, and some of them, it enhances it.
They seem to be becoming an all-important thing, and so much money has been spent on them these days. Do you think that they're overshadowing what you, well, not just you, but what everybody's trying to get across, and that's the music?
I think it's like anything else, it's tender if you're not careful, you know. It's like the show can take over the music if you're not careful. But at the same time, there's always some real gems. And obviously, it's become an important way of selling records these days.
All we hear is radio caca, radio goo, radio gaga. All we hear is radio caca, radio gaga.
Roger, despite selling over 55 million records, you've never really been the darling of the critic set. Does that annoy you?
It used to. They were very cruel and sometimes wrong and factually wrong, you know.
Has there been any really nasty incidents in the last few years?
No, just wrong. Just when they get facts wrong, you know. You just cry all the way to the bank.
Looking at your concerts and your videos over the years, you always look as though you're having fun. Is that the case?
I think it should be fun. I mean, if it was a bore, I think we'd all start doing different things. And I think, in one way, we are in a very lucky position, because, I mean, we can have fun and earn our keep at the same time. I know it's everybody wants to do that. And I think we're in a very lucky position. But it is hard work, too. But it's like you say, I mean, we like to have fun, and I hope that comes across. Otherwise, it would be a very boring world to live in.
Blunt bob like that, it just looks...
It's Good Night Australia, and here's the number one prediction coming up. Already they have a big hit with Shout.
Those who don't know them, well, here's a taste.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.
The Royal Rockers, they're called, a British band. They've sold over 55 million records. That's even more than Pat Boone. They've pioneered rock video as an art form. All pretty impressive stuff. So from Queen, would you please welcome their drummer, Roger Taylor. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks
nice to be here.
On this wet day. Bring back memories of England.
Yes, it's just like being at home, actually. I was expecting lots of sunshine.
No, I mentioned early on that, in fact, all you guys have degrees, and we'll talk about those. Fairly unusual for a rock band. Why would a bunch of bright boys go out on Sydney Harbour in the rain yesterday?
The weather wasn't actually too bad on the boat trip. Just really, I think, to get everybody in our crew together to have a good time. Unfortunately, one of the boys had a couple too many beers, I think, and decided to take a dip.
He fell overboard?
No, he dived overboard, actually. Jumped overboard.
Still out there swimming somewhere, or did you pick him up?
He could be. No, I think the police picked him up.
No, it wasn't one of the band. It was one of the roadies, was it?
That's right. Oh, yeah. It's all their fault.
It wouldn't be the clean-cut boys up front.
No, we wouldn't do anything like that.
I mentioned degrees. I mean, there's no question about you standing amongst professionals as musicians. Let's talk about degrees. You've got a degree in what?
Biology. A BSc.
A Bachelor of Science in Biology. Now, you studied dentistry for a while.
I did indeed, yes. I really didn't get on with dentistry very much. I don't think they got on with me very well. And
the dentist or the patients?
I didn't really want to work for a living, for a start. And, I really didn't get that far. I did about 18 months of it, actually. And that's just to the stage where you start getting to look in people's mouths, you know. It's all on people who weren't alive, you know, up to then. But, so I just gave it up and switched to the biology.
All right. John, what's he got?
John's got a very good electronics degree.
First class
honours, yeah.
Right, and there you go. Yeah, we'll see. And Freddie?
Freddie's got a graphics diploma, yeah.
Illustration and graphics?
That's right.
Right, there you go, a likely lad. Very much. And Brian?
All typical pictures posed at home. Brian, yes, that thing has... he's got a physics degree.
A physics degree. You'd pick him in one,
he's
wouldn't
also
you?
An astronomer, actually.
Certainly looks like one. Now, you've mentioned... I mentioned the 55 million albums you've sold. You've been playing for so long now, for 14 years. Is there a big difference between live performances, as you're doing in Australia now, and recording?
Yes, I think that you have to look on the two as being essentially completely different things. Recording is a different art form to live performance. A live performance is sort of excitement on the night, and we try to bring a lot of visuals into our live performances. And not so much to exactly recreate the records. That's not really the idea. It's to sort of play the same songs, but with an extra piece of excitement, I think, that comes from being live.
Which is part... I mean, that was fun. The photos were fun, of course, but it's dressing up and the gear and so on is all part of it. That was serious stuff, was it? Right. But the gear, obviously, in yeah. terms of visual...
Well, that was just... That really was a piece of our sort of humour. I mean, that really was humorous and... some of the things are more serious than others. You know?
Yes, well, 14 years, again, is a long time for a rock and roll band to yeah. stay together and be successful. You've clearly paid your dues.
Yes, and it shows this morning. Yes, it's a very long time. I think we're one of the longest remaining bands to stay with all the original members. I can't think of anybody who's really been together longer.
No.
With all the originals, you know.
Is there a secret to it? I mean, do you spend much time together when we're not recording or not on the road? Are you good friends apart?
We spend some time, but obviously we get away from each other quite a lot as well.
Yeah. You know? Is that the secret?
One of the secrets, I think, yeah. And also, you've got to have the odd break, you know, yes. which we do.
I mentioned that you had pioneered video rock, especially with Bohemian Rhapsody. We've got a clip of that, and we'll talk about this, the rock clips.
Of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo,
Magnifico.
Oh, I'm just a poor boy and nobody loves me.
Now, that doesn't... We get used to a lot of money being spent on video clips. Yes. That was, in fact, one of the cheapest ever made, wasn't it?
Well, I think it was cheap, really, because it was one of the first that was ever made. So there was no scale of values, really, then.
$8,000 as against Michael Jackson's $500,000.
That's right. Yeah.
These days, what I mean, what was your attitude? Did you think right from the outset that video clips would be the way to go?
We did, in fact, yes, because we were involved. Our management company at the time was involved in one of the first video companies, the sort of independent video companies in England, and yes, we did think it would do really what it's done. But it took a long time to persuade some of our record companies.
Did it really? Yes. And what sort of money would you be spending now on video clips?
Well, unfortunately, anything £100,000 or $200,000, really. And it's just ridiculous. It's got out of hand.
Yeah, here's another clip there. But I mean, how much say do you have in it, Roger, in terms of the production of these videos?
Oh, a lot. We managed to control our video output, and as the same with the audio stuff, you know, we managed to have complete creative control. But we work with the director, using our ideas.
Is it another outlet for you, apart from the music, after this?
It is. I find videos very tiring, actually, to make. And I'd rather be just making the music, actually, than drugging ourselves to death making videos. It's a very slow process.
Yeah. Do you sit down, as you do with, obviously, planning a record or planning an album, you sit down and work out what you're going to do and how you're going to do it. Do you sit down on this one as well and plan out pictures and
new ideas? Yeah, that's exactly what we do, really. And we have a storyboard and we go over and over it with the director and the guys who's building the scenery and everything. Just like making a small film, I suppose, really.
Yes. Is it a question of being more outrageous than the last one? Because, I mean, if you look at them, let's say on something like Countdown here in Australia or the music television in America, it seems that every group has got a video clip, so you obviously have to be better than the last.
Yes, in a way, you're sort of building an impossible staircase, really. But the same with the live shows. Each one is supposed to be bigger than the next, unless you want to go straight to the sort of minimalist.
Do you think, has the music business reached a stage where you have to do a video clip to succeed?
Unfortunately, I think it has, yes, really. Or maybe somebody could come up with a really special record that would make it on its own merits. Mm. But I think, really, these days, to really crack the whole world, you need the video clips.
As one of the most successful groups to come out of Britain, you have a reputation for being extravagant, rather enjoying your wealth.
Well, it's quite fun, isn't it? You must be rich.
Why not spread it around? But what do you indulge in?
I try to spread it around. I suppose we like just the usual things. I think some of us like cars, and somewhere nice to live is always nice to have.
Just the usual things like a Ferrari or a castle?
Well, yeah. I don't know about the castle, but
Well, I just wonder about the age of groups now. We've had Rod Stewart celebrating his 40th birthday and Mick Jagger celebrating his, poor old devils, and you're 35.
Yes.
Do you see yourself as a geriatric rocker?
I hope not, no. I don't know, perhaps it'll grow up. I mean, Chuck Berry's getting on, isn't he? I don't know, perhaps we can grow old gracefully and still keep doing it somehow.
I don't mean it as a cliche question, though, but I mean, it obviously is one, isn't it? What do you do? I mean, you obviously don't need to do it now for the money. You're obviously enjoying it.
Yeah, very much so. Yeah, in fact, that's why we do it, really. We do it because we enjoy it, for the enjoyment, really, I think. But, I don't know, one day they'll send us to the glue factory, I suppose.
With the rest of the old nags. Yeah. But do you ever think about, let's say the Beatles, we got used to the Beatles together and then they had to split because they were just, they'd reached a stage where they couldn't get on, where they're doing nothing. You obviously haven't reached that stage.
Not really. I think they had so much media attention and everything, and we haven't really had that kind of career. It's been a different kind of thing. But people forget, I think the Beatles were actually only together for 7 years.
Yes.
Which is a surprisingly short time, really.
Do you get old when you see the reception for people like, do you feel old with people like Boy George and...
No, I feel great. I think that's what it's all about. Whether he'll be here next year, who knows, you know. Maybe he will, maybe he won't.
Yes, but I understand there was a story that where you had dinner with him once, and he told you that, in fact, he'd...
We had him up for tea, actually, and...
Boy George for tea.
We were doing a festival in Italy, and he came up, and he was very charming, and his drummer, and he just said, God, I used to love you guys when I was 12. So Freddie and I felt very old.
Well, you're halfway through the Australian tour. You've got how much to go?
We've got 4 shows in Sydney.
Right.
Which start on Thursday.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks for coming. Good luck. Good to have you back again.
Thank you for having me.
Roger Taylor, ladies and gentlemen. What I should have said, of course, was halfway through the Sydney tour. Yeah.
Well,
lots to go. Yeah. Lots to go. Okay. You can certainly catch them.
There you go. Do you get intimidated by the size of that crowd?
No, the bigger the better. In everything.
I love that.
Your body, yeah.
Body language. Body language.
Flamboyant Freddie Mercury with rock and roll champions Brian May, John Deacon and Roger Taylor. Heartbeat City returns after the break with Alexander O'Neill, Daryl Hall, Europe and David Lee Roth.
merchandise. I pray you and I'll pity you. I'll try to fill you, to thrill you, I'll do plenty of goodbyes. We'll give you crazy performance. We'll give you grounds for divorce. We'll give you fierce resistance. Let me introduce you.